Irreverent humor, including nudity and sexual material.
Yanky Panky! Yanky Panky! Yanky Panky!
If you were dead, I'd have such happy memories of you. But you keep tainting them with every half-assed thing that you do. I'd look so pretty in black, I'd say how much I want you back. You say, you make me feel so alive, and that makes me wanna die. Darling, I'm just dying to grieve for you. If you were dead, I'd have such happy memories of you. Come on, shift your mortal coil, darling. If you were dead, I'd have such happy memories of you. Hello, Britain. My name is Tennessee. I'm 100% country with just a hint of polyester. Isn't this a pretty song? In country music, we love a tragic ballad. In fact, our motto is no pain, no financial gain. Anyways, I'm forgetting myself. Y'all are right welcome here to my show, Yanky Panky. I'm gonna give you a taste of the United States. 100, yes, a little fatty around the edges, you betcha. But I promise it'll tickle your gullet and make you chuck up your innards, but in a nice way. So tuck in that napkin and let's get on with the show. If you were dead, I'd have such happy memories of you. I want to see you laid out. If you were dead, I'd have such happy memories of you. Yeehaw! On Yanky Panky tonight, the Reverend Wendell shows us his new Easter bonnet. We'll meet some all-American gals who show us how they party. Gee, do you think they're real? And we showcase the latest in sofa technology. Plus, we find out why this woman ain't shaved for 20 years. But first, a fashion item about bikinis. At least I assume that's what it's about.
The coolest guy,
the prettiest girls.
We're ready to roll.
It's bikini.com!
For adolescent computer nerds looking for cheap thrills on the internet, the search using the word bikini usually provides what they're after. Now, a brand new website is likely to improve their chances of learning about the female form. Set up by TV producer Gail Sonnenschein, together with her brother Howie, Bikini.com is a flesh fest of international beach babes, all sporting the ultimate icon of Californian lifestyle.
Bikinis, bikinis.
And more bikinis.
Here we are in Cancun, Mexico, shooting our Bikini.com calendar. Let's go check it out.
Bikini watching is America's favorite spectator sport, and really Bikini.com celebrates that and takes that to a whole new level. And we are good, clean fun. We put everybody up on a pedestal, and it's all-American sex appeal taken to the max. We are not Shakespeare, but we are definitely what people like.
Despite as many as 20 million hits a week to what the cyber siblings describe as the world's biggest beach party, they are keen to point out that it's not just the babes in bikinis who are pulling in the punters. They claim it's also the fascinating pages on sport, shopping and fashion, which is attracting their target audience of 18 to 24-year-old dysfunctional men.
The kind of guy that comes to Bikini.com is a really cool guy.
I'm going to check it out as soon as I get back. I haven't seen much space I got on my computer. That's how much hard drive is.
They're all very nice people. They send really nice fan letters to the supermodels because we're not a sleazy, you know, we're really wholesome. We're all about fun.
Ta-da! Bikini.com supermodel, Lola Jean Craven.
Being about as interested in clean, wholesome fun as President Clinton, Yanky Panky ignored the bits on sports, shopping and fashion and headed straight for the bikini babes themselves. The website's cyber stars are fast eclipsing the likes of Kate and Naomi and are becoming supermodels in their own right. Favourite amongst internet surfers is real-life surfer Jessica Bishop, nicknamed the Beachcomber. Tonya Watts has taken her nickname, the Country Girl, to heart and now sings to packed audiences at country festivals. But Yanky Panky's favourite starlet is Irene Krupnik.
She's too far apart. Sorry, turn sideways to me instead. Beautiful. Keep moving. I get the lights on her, guys. She's beautiful. There you go, much better. Good girl.
Discovered by Howie on a Manhattan shopping trip, the 5 foot, 6 inch Russian-born bombshell fled her homeland so that she could come to America and model
bikinis, bikinis,
and more bikinis.
In fact,
I've so much bikinis that I lost track of it.
But no matter how big the swimwear collection gets, the philosophy is always the same.
The smaller, the cuter, the better.
We really choose the girls not just on their looks, but mostly on their personality, and they have to be beautiful on the inside.
I love the colors in there. It looks like paradise. She's so all-American and sweet.
They're real, they're approachable, they're gorgeous.
I want to go there right now.
Do they have to have any special qualities? Yes, they have to have a great heart, they have to be sweet and nice, and they have to look pretty darn good in a bikini.
As with any shameless exploitation of girls in bikinis, licensing deals have been set up for every conceivable form of merchandise. They're even trying to flog their own anthem, which they claim is inspired by our very own Spice Girls.
Bikini, come open up and make it my day.
Sympathetic to the ethos of girl power, the Dynamic Duo's latest venture is a site dedicated to hunks in trunks. But what they really, really want is their first British supermodel. They've even come up with a nickname for the proposed British babe already.
Actually, it'd be good to have a bikini comp supermodel called the Yanky Panky. She's the Yanky Panky. That's a good one.
Yanky Panky!
Oh, excuse me. I was just relaxing and looking through some of the many letters I received after last week's show, such as this one from Mrs. Rhoda McDervish from Scotland. She writes, I won't attempt the accent. Dear Tina, me and my girlfriend, it's okay, I guess she means the woman she lunches with, we would like to know how we can look as fantastically toned and trimmed as you do. Well, Rhoda, actually you can. All you have to do is mail me £15.99 and you'll get this video.
Brothers and sisters, are your souls heavy because your bodies are too weighty? Well, just follow my diet. Cry yourself thin, lose weight through being unhappy.
I'd rather be thin and unhappy than fat and in love. Contentment makes you greedy. Stay home and stuff yourself. Being lonely makes me nervy, but nervy keeps me skinny. You can keep partners and TV dinners, your double dates with a chocolate cake. I'm undersexed and I'm over-anxious, but at least I'm underweight. I'm undersexed and I'm over-anxious, but at least I'm underweight. 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, for those of you who can't afford my aerobics video, and I should imagine there are a heck of a lot of you out there, here's another suggestion. Always eat in the nude, because if you're butt-ass naked, just before you lift that hamburger to your lips, you can look down and see that little old roll of fat. I can't do it myself. You know, it really keeps you motivated.
Yanky Panky! Yanky Panky!
Every August, airheads from all over the globe congregate in the middle of the Black Rock Desert in Nevada for a beach party with a difference. Forced to move from its original home on a San Francisco beach by local police 10 years ago, the Burning Man Festival is a week-long fusion of performance art, body paint, and good old-fashioned nudity. It's attended by as many as 25,000 space cadets, the type of people who integrate uneasily into normal society.
You stop watching me! Stop it!
And it's unique in that all festival-goers create their own art, and none of them take any notice of anyone else's.
This is a shower device. It has a misting umbrella, and it also has, a 200 PSI hose for washing off the masses. I can do about six women at a time with this.
I'm Nambla the Clown, creating Touch the Finger.
Nambla, a.k.a. Greg, a computer programmer, helped to launch the festival in 1986, and he's been attending ever since. His artistic statement involves dressing up like a clown.
Anyone who paints their teeth is really a severe drag queen. I think Burning Man is one of the last vestiges of bohemia. Everything's being commodified. Camp has been commodified. A lot of social constructs have been totally sold and mass marketed. And Burning Man's something you can't do that to.
Burning Man's centerpiece is a 40-foot human effigy, which gives the festival its name, and which is burnt to the ground as part of a spectacular fireworks display on the final night. However, few festival-goers remember what the effigy represents, and even fewer care.
People try to put some meaning on the Burning Man itself, as a rebirth, reclamation, whatever. I kind of think of it as accidental art. It's beautiful when it blows up, but it's really not about rebirth. It's really about blowing it up.
Equally without purpose is the festival's art. Somewhere between 60s psychedelia, Dada, and Mad Max, the creative force behind this avant-garde celebration appears to be an awful lot of illegal substances.
Lights out, no one's home.
Burning Man's all about great ideas poorly executed. 2 years ago, this girl built a roller rink, and she'd been collecting little toy cars and stuff to strap on people's feet, but she forgot to bring the plywood for the roller rink. Cool idea, but done badly. If you are good with a wrench, you rule out here. If you can electrify a couch and drive it across the playa, you rock. I'm kind of jealous, actually. I can just do my eyebrows. I wish I could drive a couch. Oh well.
Some of the many great ideas poorly executed include a penis painting stall, this four-story cyberbus which ferries plucky passengers around the festival, and a communal love tent called the Sunshine Pussy Hut, which features a solar-powered vibrator.
This is the vibrator. Solar panels up top, batteries are under the bench.
As night descends on the Nevada desert, it's time to celebrate the climax of the Burning Man Festival. These days, there are dozens of smaller imitation events around the country, but Greg claims the original is still the best.
I think it might change people's perspectives about what Americans can be rather than who they are. I mean, a lot of us are loud, annoying people. I mean, I certainly am. But I think it's a really positive view of people in general.
As 25,000 stoned revelers pack up to return Black Rock Desert to its unspoiled splendor, a few visible traces of humanity remain. An inverted Stars and Stripes, which stays until next year's festival, and some unsavory stains on a wooden sheep.
There was a dude in here yesterday morning as we were eating our breakfast. Took the sheep by behind and had a girl in there, and he was totally like doing the girl in the mouth and then doing the sheep and the vibrator like this. And then the girl was here, she went like that, you know, like in her mouth, and then he did all of her face. I was eating my eggs.
After the break, we find out why domestic cleaners in Miami have such funny uniforms. We meet America's famous bearded lady. And we go partying in New Orleans. Put them away, darling. They ain't as pretty as you think. Time for a break now, but don't fret. Adverts are just God's way of telling you to be back for part two.
Yanky Panky!
Futurama brings you Earth Attack 3000, Aliens vs. the Earthlings. going to be a science fiction hero, just like Xena.
Starring a fighter pilot. With a motive.
And they spilled my cocktail.
All right, scumwads. This one's for Bender's cocktail.
Futurama's back.
Yeah, but it'll never bring back my martini. Well, who wants a martini?
Face the future. Brand new Futurama. Tuesday at 8:30, Sky One.
Cutting-edge design that you can see, advanced technology that you can't. Ford demands a closer look.
New Gardeur Spaniola. Real cherry pieces in swirls of vanilla ice cream and cherry sauce. Gardeur, made for sharing.
Tempo asks, when you have a cold, is one tissue tough enough?
Two will probably all right.
Will you test these man-sized tissues? You can even take two.
It's splitting. Oh, he's blown a hole in the tissue. Very embarrassing.
New Tempo Plus. Its four plies make it twice as strong as any other box tissue. It has a touch of aloe vera and it's soft too.
Oh, these feel better already.
Very strong, Edsy.
It must have a blow in it.
Yes, it's lovely and smooth.
New Tempo Plus. All the softness, twice the strength.
Introducing Weller's revolutionary on-off hair colouring system. When you feel like you're ready for a change, it gives you the confidence to choose the deep color you want. Then if you want, you can just go back. The Weller On-Off Hair Coloring System. On for long-lasting color, off to go back with a gentle vitamin C-enriched formula.
Weller, beautiful hair needs an expert.
Summer 2000 offers at Lampoli. Save 30% on thousands of holidays. Enjoy free insurance. And if you find the same holiday cheaper elsewhere, we'll refund the difference. Summer 2000 offers at Lampoli. A better way to get away.
With a little bit of luck, they'll make it through the night. With a little bit of luck, 3, 8, 1. When the crowd say ball, selector, 3, 8, 1.
Rewind, a journey through UK garage, mixed by the Artful Dodger from Ministry of Sound.
Water. 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 Oh. Kettle. Kettle. Kettle.
We know.
It's not a filling pot noodle snack, is it?
That's your
pot noodle. Anything else is big pants.
One way to step into a clean shower every morning is to build a new one every day. It's an awful lot of trouble, though. Much simpler is new Shower Shine from Mr. Muscle, a revolutionary way of keeping your shower clean. After you've showered, just spray a light mist. You don't have to scrub, rinse, or wipe to prevent limescale, soap, even water marks. So you'll want to spend more time in it. New Shower Shine from Mr. Muscle. It's like stepping into a new shower every morning.
And you are a doctor who can talk to animals.
The dog did not speak.
Oh, you're talking and I understand you.
Hello.
He can walk with the animals.
Yeah, how come I can understand you talk?
I don't know, maybe you're just weird.
He's suffering from his called obsessive compulsive behavior.
Throw the ball, throw the ball.
Throw the damn ball.
He can talk with the animals.
You know how to do CPR?
CPR? I can't even spell it.
Johnny, no.
That's not good.
Stop looking at me like that.
But when it comes to people...
I love you.
Yeah, baby.
This doctor could do with a little help.
Stop barking and chirping for one day.
Do a little dance. Make a little love. Get down tonight.
What's going on out there?
Uh-oh.
Hi, it's me.
Hey, honey.
Rodney, get back in your cage. Right now.
Eddie Murphy, the first showing of Dr. Dolittle, Saturday at 8, Sky Premiere. The biggest films every Saturday night, guaranteed.
Yankee Panky!
Growing up in Gusty Gulch County, Tennessee, you never know what strange critters are going to move in next door. Hey, looky here. Here's one now.
Hi.
Hi, Jenny.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good.
Say hi to the folks out there
hi,
in England.
Hi, folks out there in England.
Woo-hoo.
They're cute.
Now, Jenny and me, we're both in show business, ain't we?
Yeah.
But there the similarities end, because Jenny Miller is America's most famous bearded lady. Though, tell me, darling, how many gals like you are there in the U.S.?
You know, New York is loaded with them.
Really?
You walk down Broadway, you're going to see 10, 20, 30 in a two-block area. That's why they call me and I call myself a woman with a beard, not the bearded lady. Full of them.
My Lord, what they put in the water there. Good Lord. You know, we all know that men are kind of inarticulate, low-down, confused, you know.
Dumb,
you know,
stupid.
They have problems with their hormones, don't they?
Yeah,
that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So, don't you feel a little uncomfortable trying to look like a guy?
I'm not trying to look like a guy.
Uh-huh. You're trying to look. God, I'm on such a steep learning curve here. What are you trying to look like? You're
that's
redefining
my job.
And all that kind of
teach,
stuff?
Teach. Yeah, I just, the beard just grows in. I let it grow, so I look like this. What I'm actually doing is looking like a woman. How a lot of women would look if they grew their beard.
You know what? I don't wish to patronize y'all, but, you know, if, you know, you should decide to lose your beard, okay?
Yay.
You could do a lot worse than use my new depilatory cream, okay?
Cream.
Yeah, it's real good. Here it is. It is called Smooth As, and it's from my new QVC home shopping range. And you want to give it a try?
Well, I think I look beautiful as I am. Sorry, darling. Try someone else.
You be just who you want to be, okay? That's great. I promoted the product anyway, so it don't matter. Well, you know what, darling? You do juggling,
what?
Don't you? You do all kinds of juggling. Would you do a little juggling for me now?
I would do a little juggling for you now.
Oh, that would be so great. Don't mock my accent. You know what? I would be as thrilled as a whore in hogwash if you would, like, you know, juggle with some of these apples I just picked from my tree. Would you do that for me?
All right, darling.
Oh, God,
here I
great.
Go.
Wow. Can you eat them?
Eat them? Well, I don't know if that was in the contract, but all right, I'll see what I can do. Here we go.
Woo, my God, that is so clever. And love that, too. Whoa, you were pretty great. Thank you.
When Julia Roberts arrived at the movie premiere of Notting Hill last year, Au Naturel, her armpits turned her into an icon for hairy women the world over. Because Julia is just the tip of a furry iceberg.
There's really nothing shocking you can do anymore except stop shaving, and it freaks people out. I mean, it's really just sort of the ultimate fuck you. It's like, I'm beautiful and take it or leave it.
America is leading the way in celebrating the charms of hirsute women. Yanky Panky went to bushy Boston to comb the roots of an emerging furry fashion.
Like Lady Godiva, very nice.
When I was a teenager, I used to shave my legs below the knee, but I never really enjoyed it. I didn't really like it. You know, I used to cut myself with a razor, and that wasn't any fun. It just really annoyed me that men didn't have to shave.
Since being plucked from obscurity by an eagle-eyed photographer, Laura has become a much sought-after model. Her appearance across America's media has revealed a market that's hungry for hair.
I like hairy women, I like hairy legs.
I like hairy women because it's too much sensual.
Warmer in the winter.
I always understood Elizabeth Taylor was just like a little furry monkey. Oh well. Didn't bother all those husbands, right?
I've gotten fan mail from Canada, places all over the States. It mostly seems to be men who grew up during the 60s when women weren't shaving their legs. And they write to me and tell me, you know, that that's how they first got to like hairy women. And they like me because I remind them of the days when women could roam gloriously free and unfettered.
And Laura is part of a new breed of young Americans on the don't shave wave. Amateur adult filmmaker John Cazar has produced a range of movies celebrating furry females in their natural splendor. His latest work stars his girlfriend Nina, who's been growing her hair since they met 3 years ago.
When I was 18, 19, I used to insist that my girlfriends shaved and so on. I started to realize that there was something mysterious, something interesting about a natural woman.
I'll have to use my secret fluffing weapon.
Now that's working.
I was conditioned to feel ashamed of my body hair at once. Before, and now I'm proud of it, so it's a good feeling, and it's more comfortable.
every woman is different, and their hair pattern is also different. Some women have hairier legs, some women have hairier underarms or bush or whatever, but, you know, I think that's part of what's interesting.
The catwalks of America may remain a haven for the shaven, but as attitudes to the hirsute female form changes, is it just a matter of time before women accept the advantages of remaining just the way nature intended?
Why would women want to shave off their hair? It seems kind of strange. Why do you want to look like a prepubescent girl? I mean, that's kind of creepy. And, you know, it's a real fucker. It takes a lot of time. You have to do it every week and, you know.
Now, anyone who bought my album, Sitting on the Lord's Right Hand, knows I'm a very religious woman. But in my high-profile career, I have been sorely tempted by drugs, drink, and Diamante. And through those trying times, it's been my good friend, Reverend Wendell, who has helped keep me on the straight and narrow. And I just know he can do the same for you. So put down your beers, zip up your pants. It's time for this week's lesson from the Reverend Wendell and his Bible birds.
This is Jeremiah, a scarlet macaw. I believe the scarlets are some of the most beautiful of the macaws. Let's have the birth of Jesus again, shall we? That's when we have Christmas. Because of the birth of Jesus. When Jesus came to earth as just a little baby in Mary's arms. Right. How do you like my baby Jesus, huh? Yes. Okay, but he didn't stay dead. No, he had to grow up. He had to grow up and teach us how to love. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, mind, and strength, and thy neighbor as thyself. But then he had to die. Died for our sins, but he didn't stay dead, did he? No, he resurrected. And so now we not only have Christmas, but we have Easter. When I was a kid, we used to have an Easter parade. Yeah, all the ladies would come to church with their nice new fancy dresses and their nice fancy Easter bonnets. And that's your Easter, right?
Thank you, Yanky.
Oh, hi. Now it's time once again for Tina's Tangled Web, where I let you hitch a ride in my virtual reality stretch Cadillac down the information superhighway, stopping off to download my favorite website of the week. A word of warning, stay away from those nasty, unauthorized Tennessee websites, you hear? But if you do happen to come across one, it's not my face on that body. I swear I've never had that bit pierced in my life, and I would never put that fabric on that cushion. Anyway, warm up your webbed fingers. It's time to go surfing with Tina. For everybody who likes taking pictures of themselves butt-ass naked with a paper bag over their heads, then I've found just the website for you called Nudes Masked. And gee, there are a lot of you out there. Since the website was set up nearly 2 years ago, over 10,000 people calling themselves bagheads have sent in pictures, although there are a whole lot more of you who just want to watch. The website gets 25,000 hits a day, and the most popular nude model is someone who calls himself Willie the Wiener. I wonder why. One of the latest baghead converts is this 52-year-old nun who claims that posing nude with a bag over her head helps her focus on the Lord above. Run by a Californian couple called Albert and Christine. Oh, looky, there they are. The website even runs a dating agency for bagheads, and one of the earliest members is someone who calls himself Elephant Man. He's been waiting for a call for almost a year. They should set him up on a date with the old nun. They make a lovely couple, don't they?
Terry Tarantino fans will remember the rather bloody scene from Pulp Fiction in which John Travolta and Samuel L. Jackson clean human remains from the back of a car. But have they stopped to consider who's really responsible for mopping up a murder?
Good afternoon, AA Trauma Cleaning. How may I help you?
It's people like 57-year-old Joan Doherty. For the past 18 years, her company AA Trauma Cleaners has been cleaning up the mess left behind by the Grim Reaper, from your common or garden murder scenes to suicides and naturally expired pensioners. But Joan is the first to admit that clearing the remains of a cadaver isn't just a case of shake and vac.
I'm not in the cleaning business. Anytime that there's any stain there, that stain is gone. I mean, it is cut out and it's taken out. So if it's carpeting and padding, it goes. If it's on a wall, it's usually going to be blood or body tissue. So the wallpaper will have to be taken down and replaced. If because of odor it needs to be sealed and repainted, it'll be sealed and repainted. Did the woman pass away of natural causes or did... Okay, and she was there for how many days? 6 days. She probably really decomposed really fast.
The issue of human putrefaction is a sticky one, especially when it comes to the Sunshine State's climate.
Florida's got high humidity and high temperature. The body starts decomposing almost immediately, and within 2 hours, you've already got flies. The hotter it is in there, the faster the body's going to decompose.
Which is why Joan's team of dedicated domestics are on hand 24 hours a day to get to crime scenes at breakneck speed. AA Trauma Cleaners is like the fourth emergency service, and it's no job for the faint-hearted.
You have to be a certain type of person. I don't think anybody can just come off the street and do this. It's emotionally tough. It's physically tough as well. I mean, the heat, the conditions you're working in, but I think it's more mentally tough.
Yanky Panky chose not to film a real murder scene, but with the help of a chicken and some raspberry sauce, Joan kindly reconstructed a typical day's work.
I piss you on the light, and some of the cable, a lot of flies around, got teeth down here on the bottom floor. Also some there, and there's some stuck to the ceiling up there. Okay.
I'm going to put down the topical barrier, and then you can do the thermo.
Although forensic experts removed the body prior to the team's arrival, few scenes leave much to the imagination. Joan's no longer shocked by the carnage she encounters, but she did admit to a nauseous moment recently.
The gentleman passed away and he had skin slip. A skin slip is when the body is decomposed and it starts and the skin just slides off. Part of its head was on the chair and the scalp and some other debris. For some reason I bent down and I just felt like I was gonna go whoops. That is the first and only time that ever happened. I don't know why it did, but it did.
After a hard day sweeping human remains under the carpet, there's only one way to relax.
I take a nice long shower because I want to feel clean. Because no matter how much you wear, how much protective clothing you have on, you still feel like you need a good shower.
Good night, England.
Yankee Panky.
You know, ever since I've been over here, one thing I've noticed about you British-type people, well, beside the fact that most of you are teeny-tiny short and have real pointy gray teeth, is that you guys are all starving, nope, gagging, for some good old-fashioned entertainment. So each week in a little segment I like to call Tina's Tips, I'll be sharing with you things which will hopefully make your lives a little bit more like mine. Remember, y'all, Tina shares because Tina cares.
My tip this week is my favorite museum, the Museum of Questionable Medical Devices in Minneapolis. It's packed full of medical inventions that make your eyes water and your knees weak. The museum is nicknamed the Quackery Gallery, and the biggest quack of them all is the curator, Bob McCoy.
Step right up, ladies and gentlemen, step right up. Be prepared to be stunned and amazed.
With his trusty assistant, Bill, Bob takes us through a century of failed remedies, from the prostate gland warmer, gee, that looks like something from my mama's kitchen, to the oscilloclast, which diagnosed any illness as syphilis. Now, my favorite item is this little old Vital Power vacuum massager, designed to enlarge the penis and cure impotency. Hey, listen closely, gals. Not only does the vacuum help enlarge a fella's manhood, but it also gets into all those awkward, dusty corners where your normal vacuum cleaner never reaches. In the 1920s, it sold for $15. Seems a bit pricey to me. Nowadays, you can get a blue pill that does the same job for half that money. Hey, looky here. Bill looks like he's popped one already.
You feel better?
Yeah.
Meet hairy hippie Larry Long. By day, he languishes in the cafe bars of his sleepy New Orleans suburb, but by night, this sleeping lion turns into Louisiana's answer to Desmond Morris.
This is Yanky Panky. This is real New Orleans.
Yes, armed with a camcorder, the bespectacled Larry, whose multiple optics have inspired the nickname of Five Eyes, trawls New Orleans at carnival time studying a unique form of human behavior. Famous for its public debauchery, the Mardi Gras is renowned for female tourists spontaneously flashing their rude bits. For the last 5 years, Larry has been documenting this unique cultural phenomenon.
What attracted me to it? I love women. I love the female form. And I find it especially appealing when it's the average, ordinary girl next door. When they start flashing, to me it's a very erotic thing. It's very beautiful.
And now the amateur historian is releasing his exhibitionist videos to the public.
If I hadn't been up and rolling, I would have never got her.
The flashing through carnival goes back to the 40s.
We're not really interested in a history lesson, Larry. Let's see a tape. In a bizarre modern-day Mardi Gras tradition known as the Beads for Boobs Bonanza, female passers-by are encouraged to bear their naughty bits in return for strings of beads, bought in local stores by boys hungry for a peek. Once confined to Mardi Gras week itself, Beads for Boobs has now become popular during most weekends of the year.
Now I'm loaded for bear.
Yanky Panky joined Larry as he set off on one of his weekly safaris, hoping to add to his prize collection of over 10,000 topless tourists.
It's against social norms to be exposing yourself in a public street, but there's a combination of peer pressure, alcohol. They're basically saying, well, here's my body, I'm proud of it, give me my beads.
They were beautiful!
A lot of times you see a gal, she get all embarrassed and finally flash once, and then half an hour later you look and she's wearing 25 pounds of beads and she can't keep her clothes on, you know?
These are what's called bush beads for a very obvious reason.
Yes, the reason is that some guys want the girls to go all the way, and it's the big bush baby beads that stands the best chance of unlocking the cellar door. However, sometimes the good old-fashioned all-American fun can get a bit overheated.
Occasionally I'll get a person that will object to my taping someone. 80% of the crowd at least is drunk, and you don't want to get drunks riled up. The only times I've ever seen trouble in through is when you get the occasional bad actor in the crowd that starts grabbing on the girls.
Safely back at his well-equipped edit suite, Five Eyes assembles the evening's highlight for his latest production. As sales of his videos soar on the internet, Yanky Panky was keen to find out what was most popular amongst his worldwide client base.
There's a lot of girl and girl interaction. Sometimes it's for the larger beads, which always go for, well, something special. the guy wants. More often than not anymore, they're obliging, and it can be quite interesting. A lot of hissing, sometimes feeling each other, sometimes licking a nipple, sometimes more.
I tell you, I'm beat. I'm headed home.
In part three, we get into a hot tub with this big furry beast who seems to have the strangest effect on us ladies. It's a mystery to me.
She's sucking on my finger.
Time for a break now, but don't you go leaving me for some other floozy show. You wouldn't like to see me jealous now, would you? Thank you.
This Tuesday, they will arrive with the sole purpose of taking over our planet. In a specially extended first episode...
This gentleman is, in fact, some sort of vegetable.
...of a Sky One original production.
I'm not a complete mannequin, am I, you know?
Ugly-looking brute.
Mark Williams.
That certainly does not look normal, cadet.
And Jack Doherty are the Strangerers. Tuesday at 9 on Sky One.
Take one fresh and tender kiss,
the memories you gave me,
add one stolen night of bliss.
Frank!
One girl, one boy.
So where is he?
Some grief, some joy, memories
are
made of this. Come on, get out of the car. Get out of the car.
Don't
put him on. We're running this marathon together, father and son.
Dad, it's Sunday.
The Peugeot 306. It's a family thing.
Who's got it?
You lot are a bunch of animals.
New cup of soup?
Extra. Do you want some?
Easter!
This time,
he's stealing Woody.
That's twice as cool.
We will not rest until he's safe in Andy's room.
Double the trouble.
Oh, no.
Getting more laughs as Woody makes new friends.
Woody!
I'm officially freaked out now.
And Buzz battles an old enemy.
Prepare to die, Buzz Lightyear.
In the biggest movie event of the year.
Wow. I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Toy Story 2.
Best dance album in the world ever, 2000. 44 of the biggest dance hits from Wamdu Project. Fierce and Lou Bega.
A little bit of Monica in my life.
Sash, Khalees, Eiffel 65. The biggest dance tunes from Alice DJ and Fenger Boys. It just has to be the best dance album in the world ever, 2000.
EasyVision all-day monthly disposable contact lenses from Specsavers are designed to be the most comfortable lenses in the world. They're made from a special material which retains moisture more effectively. They don't dry out like ordinary lenses can. And that means you can wear them for longer. So whatever else might be irritating you by the end of the day, at least your eyes stay fresh. EasyVision all-day monthly disposable lenses from Specsavers Opticians cost from just £7.50 per pair. But if you call in now, you can try them for 30 days free.
When you're ready for a really powerful experience, try Amazing Airwaves from Wrigley's. Just one chew releases a hit of fast-acting menthol and eucalyptus vapor to help your nose feel really clear. Airwaves taste great, and the vapor goes on and on and on. Sugar-free Airwaves. The vapor hits you fast and lasts.
I'll tell you something.
With theoretical mathematics, you only get out the equation what you put into it. That's not always the way, but both natural and man-made phenomena show that some things that you put in are going to give you far, far more than you expected. Like Sky Digital, for instance, with the movies. For the same money as you're paying right now, they'll give you four times as money for the dosh. It's no wonder you fun folk changing to Sky Digital, eh?
For more information, or to get Sky Digital, call 0870 240 2000.
Well, howdy, y'all. This here is my good friend and country music superstar, Scooter Lee. Say hi to the British folks, Scooter.
Well, hello.
That's so great. Are they treating you nice in the UK?
They are treating me so great here. I just love it here in this country.
Ooh, aren't they weird over here, though? Couldn't you just, like, hug them all because they're all so small and stuff?
Yeah, I could just...
You notice that?
Yes, I noticed that. I could just hug them and pocket them and take them home with me.
For all you British folks who ain't too sure who Scooter Lee is, you just have a look at this.
Come on, everybody, it's a honky-tonk twist.
12 years spent recording in Nashville, combined with her New Orleans background, have made Scooter Lee famous for her unique brand of honky-tonk country music. Her boot-scootin', ball-bustin' vocals and ability to get people dancing anywhere, even in a courtroom, have earned her the nickname of the Queen of Line Dancing.
It's over.
Now, just like me, Scooter is a traditionalist when it comes to her country roots, and I mean having hair as big as haystacks. Here she is with an electrifying hairdo, singing her post-feminist anthem for all of us ladies who've ever been dumped by their man, called Deal With It. Go on, gal, tell it like it is.
Deal with it.
That hair, that's just so big. I mean, I love big hair myself, but how'd you get some sleep at night?
Well, I just, it's cushiony.
That's true. Don't you get a crick in your neck, though?
No? No, I just wake up and come up just looking like this.
Well, that's so great. Hey, you know what occurred to me? The British folks, okay, they think a scooter is one of the cheapest and easiest rides in town. Did you hear that? What'd you think about that?
Well, you know, it's like I've been known to be a little cheap myself now and then.
Yeah, well, that's good. Let's celebrate our cheap side. We can reclaim that as a concept.
Yes, we can.
I certainly do. So, listen, as a queen of line dancing, honey, doesn't it get tiresome having a bunch of guys kind of doing weird things behind you all the time?
I just push them when they get in the way.
Do you ever kick them?
Yeah, and I pull them when I need them again.
Oh, okay. I like that action. I must learn that one. We'll do that one later. You know, honey, it has been so thrilling meeting you. You know, you're one of my heroines from way back.
Well, thank you very much.
No, it's been a pleasure. And you get to meet me, so it's been so perfect.
It's just, it don't get any better than this, honey.
I know. Really? You know why? Well, while Scoot and I tone up our tonsils and limber up our larynxes, here's something to keep you perkier than a panhandler's pony.
Yanky Panky! Yanky Panky!
He's a cartoon character. He's fun.
Yeah, everybody wants to be like him.
He cracks me up. He just takes liberties, though.
The heroic figure these shiny, happy people are talking about is 46-year-old Ron Jeremy, the world's most famous male porn star.
You got me in this mess, you're gonna get me out of this mess.
Nicknamed the Hedgehog because he's small, fat, and very hairy, the emperor of erotic films has appeared in more than 1,600 blue movies.
Says here, made by Goodyear.
And directed nearly 100 more.
Action!
He's the last person you'd expect to find in a bordello on his day off, but it seems that Randy Ron just can't keep his hands off the fairer sex. Yanky Panky spent a weekend with the legendary Lothario at America's most notorious house of ill repute, preparing to celebrate its 25th birthday with a swinging party. A self-styled ladies' man, Ron was quick to make use of the leisure facilities.
He just has a pillow.
I'm well aware of the fact that if I wasn't an extra in movies, these girls wouldn't give me the time of day. Because my looks faded when I stopped working out in the gym, and I started working out in the buffet. So I'm aware that if it weren't for porn, I wouldn't get dick, let alone pussy. I'm living proof that anybody can get laid.
Ron's illustrious career started at 25 when he posed for Playgirl magazine in the 70s. Ever since, the man known as the Woody Allen of porn has been charming the pants of his lady friends with his sparkling wit.
I want to show you my penis, but I'm standing over here. My dick is up parked in the car.
and proving to life's losers that even the ugly guys can get the girls.
Lily, you don't have to do this. I'm not a charity case.
This isn't charity, it's pleasure.
It's difficult to believe that the sex movie superstar was once a special needs teacher in New York, and Ron still holds a teaching license to this day.
I enjoyed teaching, it was a nice career. I felt good about it, but I wanted to be an actor.
Unfortunately, Ron's thespian abilities have always been overshadowed by a more impressive asset.
Ron has a huge fucking cock.
Yes, at over 10 inches, Ron's todger is one of the biggest in the industry. But it's also revered for another prize quality, his ability to control climaxes with pinpoint accuracy.
Controlling one's orgasm is something you actually learn by being in the business. At the beginning, you don't really know how to do it that well. You're glad you come at all. But as you get to be better known and you can actually practice and you're in front of the camera a lot, you get a little more control on your orgasm. So now I have a thing in most of my films where I have the girl count down from 20. She'll say, Ronnie, you're such a tough guy, I want you to come in exactly 20 seconds. 20, 19, 18, 17. And I run on zero. Freak of the week, baby, tell me, are you a
freak? Oh, I really gotta go. The master of self-control exercises rather less restraint when it comes to celebrity schmoozing. When Ron launched a pop career with his rap record Freak of the Week, the Hollywood Tart invited dozens of his celebrity chums to sing along with Ron. Freak of the week, yeah, are you a freak? He's even shot one of his erotic movies at the Hollywood home of film star Lynn Redgrave. And as one of only a handful of porn actors to break into the mainstream, Ron has advised on movie blockbusters Boogie Nights and 9½ Weeks.
Don't go away. Warner was kind of chic right now. It's going through a very interesting heyday. With films like, you know, Boogie Nights, People vs. Larry Flynt, the Howard Stern movie, Private Parts, with President Clinton having his highest ratings while he was getting blown in office. I mean, people are beginning to get a good attitude about sex.
As the Moonlight Bunny Ranch's 25th birthday party got into full swing, Ron was clearly the center of attention.
Ronnie will have sex with no less than 8 girls tonight.
But no one imagined the sex would start before the hors d'oeuvres. As Ron enjoyed all the attention at the expense of distinguished local guests, Yanky Panky wondered what was next for the man who can't help mixing business with pleasure.
Just to keep marketing myself and having a good old time in life. You know, I mean, because I'm single, I'm not cheating on anybody, you know, so I'm just trying to enjoy my life.
And judging by the way our interview progressed,
she's sucking on my finger.
Ron is obviously a man who's always on the job.
Next week on Yanky Panky. I know we breed big gals in the States, but this is just plain ridiculous. We go big game hunting in the Nevada desert. And we visit a good old-fashioned American beauty pageant. Well, I hope those girls don't catch a chill now. Yanky Panky! Now, the chorus of this song is easier than falling off a log jam. So come on, join us at home now as me and Scoot sing a country classic. Let's go.
Woo-hoo! I beg your pardon. I never promised you the Rose Garden. Along with the sunshine. There's gotta be a little rain sometime. When you think you gotta give, so live and let live or let go. Oh, I beg your pardon. I never promised you a rose garden along with the sunshine. There's gotta be a little rain sometime.
Can I just say it is such a thrill to have you on my show, darling.
Well, thank you so much, Tina. I'm so happy to be here.
I beg your pardon. I never promised you the rose garden.
Scootily in the hand.
I could sing you a tune and promise you the moon, but if that's what it takes to hold you, I'd just too soon let you go.
Let it go.
But there's one thing I want you to know. Your turn.
You better look before you lean. Still waters run deep. There won't always be someone there to pull you out. That's just what I'm talking about.
Come on with me now.
Smile for a while and let's be jolly. Love shouldn't be so melancholy. Come on. good times while we can. And I beg your pardon, I never promised you Rose Garden. Along with the sunshine, there's gotta be a little rain sometime. I beg your pardon, I never promised you Rose Garden. Along with the sunshine, there's gotta be a little rain sometime.
Oh honey, I beg your pardon.
I never promised you Rose Garden.
So
along with the sunshine, it's gotta be a little rain sometimes. Yeah.
All right.
Woohoo!
I was eating my eggs.